see that?
Yep.
Awesome.
Okay. My name is Mark Trueman. I grew up skiing at Whistler. We would go up every other weekend. So I had an early passion for skiing because it was a family activity. Also, they've always been very encouraging. I've got an amazing family that have always supported whatever passions I had.
When we first met, his rafting career and what he was doing was like, and he was climbing in Thailand, he came back and he's gonna go out rafting and that's his job. And I'm like, who is this guy?
He's a he's a visually striking fella. He's got the big beard, he's kind of short. Nelson has a bit of a mystique about it, it's kind of a hippie town. And Mark fits that mold quite well. You know, he's like a Kootenai folk story.
Someone just started calling me the freak at one point because I was a little different. I also had a penchant for jumping off high things and doing things that had fairly high risk associated with them. I started spelling it F-R-I-E-K, and then my friends extended it to Friekers.
He's an incredibly knowledgeable person when it comes to the outdoors. If I broke my leg in the back end of nowhere, there might not be anyone I'd rather be. Like, his knowledge is tip top. A decade ago, Mark was working as a river guide in the summertime. At the pinnacle of river guiding, he's about as good as you can get, world class.
And stop! Hang on! And back paddle, boardy, back paddle! And stop, board paddle!
And it's an all-encompassing job, and it wipes you out, destroys you.
I worked something like, you know, 146 days in a row one season, and most of those days would be 18, 20 hour days. You're always on. And so, yeah, that takes a toll on you.
At a young age, you can do that and you can just keep on trucking, but eventually the body gets worn down and the gears get rough.
Probably the biggest challenge is that for 5 months of the year, I didn't see my wife. And not only did I not see her, but I would, at best, talk to her once every week or two.
And so I think his drive to get out became less and less, if that was possible.
Being away from here, being part of our life and our community in Nelson, as well as our relationship, so holding the fort kind of at home and like doing the stuff here with the animals and making decisions and yeah, going through what I'm going through in a way, I would say solo.
Now I end up working in web development and geographic information services. Basically sitting at a computer, I'm becoming physically limited as well.
I was always the instigator. I was always like, hey, we're going skiing tomorrow, hey, we're going skiing. And I can tell you now, I don't think I've ever told him this, but I'm pretty sure that he's never called me to say, hey, we're going skiing. I would always call Mark.
Flip the page, give it some more, getting out of my way. I was high.
Hey! How's it going?
Bulletproof, forever waiting. Thank you. I thought I was what I told. I thought I was.
Partly, I have no idea how I'll be at the end of the day.
Right.
I might be destroyed. So, I mean, that'll be a factor, for sure. I come around here, we're gonna come up here into what's called West Weimar. Reason that we've chosen that is because it's north-facing.
Yes.
So it will be in the shade and we'll have had less sun. Yeah, I mean, the other option was to go down into 5 Mile here. On the backside of White Queen, but the skin up back out is quite arduous.
Because I haven't tightened this up. Is my phone okay?
That's fine, yep.
Okay.
Yep. Nice, far enough apart.
So,
I mean,
but
this is
like we're scoring today.
Oh, we're scoring.
Sweet!
How's it going, you're the master?
Good.
You guys went out and toured, and so yeah, it feels like it's coming back a little bit. I think what I would like to see for his adventure spirit that's still in there is for him to come up with something that he wants to do for him, and I would love to join as a person who loves him and hopes he could find that passion again. I'm not going to be able to tell him how to do it and where to get it from, and that has to come from within and be intrinsic.
It's getting outside, and this time it's because he wants to do it and it's not for work, and he doesn't have that same pressure as a guide working for clients versus there's no pressure with family.
It's great to be able to springboard off of your youthful passion. You know, there's no excuse not to go when you're there and excited.
And there's no one here. It felt like the old days.
Being able to be there on your first ski tour. All older people say this, but it's amazing how time flies. I still am wrestling with you being an adult. I still think of you as this young kid.
He's his own person, and I'm only a phone call away if he wants to go for a ski.